Yes, I insist on calling you doctor. I return calling him doctor again. Because you just, your PA didn't drop from the sky, you worked for it.
Do you know what a PhD is? It's merely a certificate that says that you are competent to begin research on your own, that you've been tested by the methods of the university, and you know how to put together material based on original research, you know how to quote your sources and so on. So it's the beginning of an academic career. It's ridiculous for anybody to be carried on his head for the rest of his life.
Well, at some point, you like a pentate doctor.
No, it's people who insist on that. Do you know, I'll tell you something very interesting. I've lived in many parts of the world, I've met many different people, and some of the best educated people I've met have never been to school, because education is not about diplomas. And some of the most ignorant people I've met have a pile of degree and professor of this and that. So it's not about that. Education is not about paper qualification. Mm-hmm. And many of the people who have left Nigeria have been functional illiterates, because being literate is not a question of knowing how to write your name. Mm-hmm. People are educated if in their own tradition they know things, right? They understand the world. Being educated is about understanding the world and being able to analyze things and relate things to each other.
So what pains you the most when you look at our country today, especially now we've had several years of democracy, more than 16 years of democracy, where of uninterrupted.
I would have disagreed with you, not had democracy.
Oh, really?
We've had some imitation of the what we believe is the Western version of democracy. We had democracy long before the British came. Don't forget, our civilization, our history goes back to thousands of years.
We've done some work in this area.
Yes, of course. We're the descendants of the people who built the pyramids of Egypt. We're the descendants of Sundiata Keita, who created the Mali Empire, the first African empire, which mistakenly the Arabs called Ghana, actually Wagadu, was created by us, and there was the Songhai Empire. Then you have Benin, you have Ife, you have Oyo, you have Nupe. We are a people with a history and a civilization. We know how to rule.
So what happened?
What happened is that there's a new class, the Western educated elite that came in.
Like you?
No, I'm not one of them. I will tell you why. These are the people who started out as the catechists and the messengers of the British colonialists. And they now had different values from what our values are. And so when the independence was coming, they grabbed what they thought was the Western mode of democracy, but it wasn't, because the political party in Africa has no relationship with what the party is in Europe or in the US. They have no ideology. They have, the political party in Africa is often a tribal association or an association of looters. That's what is happening. We should do away with political parties. It has no relevance. We know how to rule people. And that ruling people means involving them from the village level. You see, the African traditional ruler was never a despot. He had to carry along with him different layers of, authority, from the village to the community, and also the associations of professional people like the hunters, the fishermen, and so that there was consultation. That's why we would sit down and talk things through. Everybody would be carried by the decision, even if they agreed, they disagreed to begin with. That's democracy. What we're operating now leads to corruption, because they spend so much money to get elected. And they have no mission. They have nothing to do but to loot.
This sounds kind of hopeless.
I beg your pardon?
What the picture you're painting is like, so what's
no,
the future?
No, let's discard what is not working now.
Is
not
that
working.
Possible?
Yes, it's possible. We need a revolution. We need to do away with all these politicians and political structures. Nigerians need to be ruled by themselves. We need to mobilize our grassroots structure. Look at what's happening now. We have a big economic crisis, and they're still listening to World Bank and IMF, who, those people are our enemies. Their mission is to take us back to slavery. Nobody in their right senses should listen to them. China never listened to them. Singapore didn't listen to them. Malaysia didn't listen to them. I don't know why in Nigeria today they say they want to hear what the IMF has to say. It's ridiculous. The head of the IMF came here, the head of state himself found time to sit down with her. It's a waste of time. Those people are plotting our downfall. We should never listen to them or give them.
You know, people think you're just a ranting old man.
I'm not a ranting old man because my views have always been justified. 8 years ago, I wrote several newspaper articles to say why Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala should never be appointed Minister of Finance. She knows nothing. Yes, at that time. When Buhari was coming to power, I wrote an article called "Is the Economy Stupid?" Is the economy, the key is economy. If you don't mobilize people to solve the economic problems, no matter what grammar you're talking about, change it will never
so
work.
So facing corruption rather than economy is not good in your opinion?
No, facing corruption has to go hand in hand. But you have to give people jobs. You have to create opportunities. We have so many banks, but the banks they're a scam. The banks create nothing. The banks spend their time round-tripping the Nigerian naira. You know, they spend their time banking money for governors and other corrupt people. Look at all that's coming out now. We don't need the banks. We need industries. We need to mobilize our people. We need agriculture on a big scale. You know, when the Americans were going through the Great Depression, they created so many jobs. You know, they created opportunities for labor-intensive activities. Now they say they're looking for foreign investors. Foreign investors will never come here to help you. We have to sink or swim by our own means. After all, all right, go ahead.
No, I just wonder though, I mean, it's interesting talking to you because, I mean, you feel you've seen a lot,
yeah.
Right? But you're not a politician and you never did try to be a politician.
I will tell you something. 95% of people from good families or good background have never gone into politics in Nigeria. It's left mostly.
Isn't that where the problem is?
No, it's not the problem because the system is wrong. If you ask me to come and serve on a community basis, you know, I can devote time to that, but I can't go and be looking for vote or, you know, canvas political party. Because I don't believe in the political party. And most people who are serious in Nigeria know that the kind of politics that are being played in Nigeria is for ne'er-do-wells.
But if we keep saying that, then nobody will make a change.
No, the young people need to be in the forefront of a revolution. Unfortunately, they've been captured by the church. They're spending all their time in night vigil. And if they're not in night vigil, they're watching English football. You know, the average young person in Nigeria today, asking what's the capital of Cameroon, he doesn't know. He's never heard of Nkrumah. He's never heard of Patrice Lumumba. But he knows the name of all the English footballers. In my opinion, they should ban all that English football on our television. Our young people have been totally, you know, deviated because of it. We should concentrate on what we have to do, on our history, on the things we have to create. I launched an initiative some time ago to raise money for the young people to create cooperatives. They should create industries of their own. They shouldn't wait for anybody to employ them.
What happened to that initiative?
Well, neat. I'm meeting with some friends now. We need to raise, because the banks will not loan them money. The banks are useless institutions in Nigeria.
Live in Cotonou.
Yes.
But you come back to Lagos. Why?
From time to time, because there are things I need to pick up here, people I need to see.
So it's a more peaceful place? You think it's better run than Nigeria?
Wonderfully peaceful. It's like the Nigeria of the 1950s and 60s when I grew up. Because everything is peaceful and quiet. I can go to any part of Cotonou in 30 minutes. I'm not in traffic jam. That's why we're going to play. Go slow, because Fela had it right. You know, there used to be gridlock in Surulere in those days. And Fela's language was very colorful.
So I'm going to sign you off again with music. But first of all, I just wanted to compare for you, because you did film, you did music, you were a diplomat.
Yeah.
And then you turn 71 in August.
Yes,
and then you look and I'm like, if I went away now, would you be happy? Would you die a happy man?
Who be?
Did your friends come for that party?
I'm a fulfilled man.
For that party that you were going to say bye-bye?
No, I didn't have it because a lot of people thought it was a morbid idea. But my idea is that people should, while they are living, while they are still here, embrace each other and say, I love you, face to face.
So what he wanted to do was have a party, invite all his friends.
And relatives.
And say, thank you for being in my life, in case I never see you again.
Now go be that. Because you can't say goodbye to a corpse. A dead person does not hear or see or feel anything. So no matter how many tons of literature you talk or write about somebody who's already gone, it doesn't affect the person. But I want to see people face to face and say to each other, I love you. You've been wonderful for me. And then if we don't see each other again, we've said goodbye. That was my idea.
Any regrets in life?
No. Regret is useless. You have to always go forward. You learn things that are useful from the past.
Major ones, for example, like being a father, being a husband, being a friend, being whatever.
No, you can't regret. It's stupid to regret. You have to go forward. What's in the past is past. So somebody said it very well in a film or something. He said, the past is another country. You don't have a visa for that country.
You know? There's no visa to that country. There's so no your daughters are based in the UK. You have Oyinbo children.
Yes, I have children, biological children, but I also have adopted children.
Many of them.
Yes, so them. I'm happy because the important thing is to share love, whether it is with your biological relatives or with your adopted relatives, it's the same thing. You have to share love. That's
so what's your message to my viewers as they're watching today? Before I play my ghost loop.
Be happy. Because you're not coming back again. The life is one chance. You come once. Whatever you don't do in this life, you're not going to come back again to do it. So do whatever you feel will fulfill you. Don't run after money. Nigeria has been destroyed by this.
But they need money.
No, you don't need money. Money is only a means of exchange. Originally, you would exchange yam for rice and things like that. But now, the doctrine of money, even the pastor, the religion they worship is the father, the dollar, the
director,
son,
play my go slow. Otherwise, I'm not going to leave this. Play my go slow. But I will just sign off.
Money is too important in Nigeria. Let you forget money. It's life that is important.
But you agree they need money.
They don't need money. They need to sustain themselves. So we need a bearable cost of living. We need the products from the hinterland to come in cheaply. We need affordable housing. The government in Lagos is building something ridiculous called Eco City. That's stupid. We should build houses for the masses.
I guess they'll forgive you. I mean,
It's stupid because even water go carry and go. You know, when time I change.
Let me play my ghost song.
All right.
Thank you, Doug. I appreciate it because you took your time to be here.
Yes. And always talk frankly.
Yes.
If it's green, I say it's green. If it's blue, I say it's blue.
You never change. You never change.
I've not changed.
Thank you very much. So, but let's play the ghost look. Can we have the ghost look now, please?
Right. This is the opening part. A beautiful solo that can be played in any part of the world.
Can everybody join us? Yeah, well, Gideon, come. Where my camera crew? I'm a fella. Go and join the world, yeah. Keep rolling, keep rolling, keep rolling. Everybody, come on, sir, come on. Everybody, join. This is a fella party, okay.
All right, let's go. Yeah, follow me.
Am I lost you, boy?